In last class, we have discussed about biomass, that is energy introduction, and also we have discussed about indirect and direct method, and also gasification, and also we have discussed about the classification, also theory of gasification. Okay. Now the classification in detail we shall read about. First is a fixed bias, fixed bed gasifier. Okay. In fixed bed gasifier, there are three types, that is updraft, downdraft, cross draft. Okay. One by one we shall read. Updraft gasifier. In updraft gasifier, the air intake is at the bottom and gas leaves at the top. You can observe this figure. Air intake is at the bottom, okay, and gas leaves at the top. Okay, the reactive agent is injected at the bottom. You can observe here, the reactive agent is injected at the bottom side of the reactor and ascends to the top, and it will go to the top. Okay, you can see the direction what they have given in the figure. While the fuel is introduced at the top and descends to the bottom. They are saying that we will inject the fuel at the bottom, this will come down. Okay, so the fuel is introduced at the top and it will descend to the bottom. The combustion reaction occurs near the grate at the bottom, followed by reduction reaction. Here I've already discussed about drying process and pyrolysis process, reduction, combustion. Okay, in each stage, what is the output? I have already said. Okay, you can observe here, in drying stage, pyrolysis, combustion, and reduction. In drying of water with eight, that is biomass is dried. In next pyrolysis process, heating without air to make a charcoal, and the combustion process we will burn and cracked tar gases. We get the output is tar gases and converting charcoal to flammable gases. So we have discussed about that, right? Each zone what happens. Here the combustion reaction occur near the grate at the bottom, followed by reduction reaction somewhat higher up in the gasifier. Drying and pyrolysis happens at the upper part. You can observe drying and pyrolysis zone happens at the upper part. In the upper part, the gases, tar and other volatile compounds are dispersed at the top part. Here, drying zone, pyrolysis zone and reduction zone. In these zones, the upper part, gas and tar and some other volatile compounds are dispersed. They are divided. Okay, they are separated. Ash is removed at the bottom. Ash is removed at the bottom side. Okay, ash pit is available. You can observe here. Ash is dispersed as removed it at the bottom side. The producer gas or syngas will have a high ash content, which should be removed before direct use. If we are using the direct gas, producer gas or syngas, we should remove the ash content before we use. Okay. It will have a high ash content, so we should remove the ash content before we use. Okay. So slagging and ash content can be severe if high ash fuels are used. Unsuitable for use with a fluffy low density fuels. What are the applications of updraft gasifier means? Packaged boilers, thermal fluid heaters, aluminium melting and annealing furnaces, and all kinds of fryer, roaster. These are the applications. Next is a downdraft. Okay, now we have discussed about the updraft. Now we shall discuss about the downdraft gasifier. Here, air is introduced at or above the oxidation zone in the gasifier, and the producer gas is removed at the bottom. They are saying that air is introduced. That means we are injecting our air is introduced here. It may be at or above the oxidation zone. It may be at oxidation, that is, it may be oxidation zone below or at the exact oxidation zone in the gasifier, and the producer gas here, what we get, the final stage producer gas is removed at the bottom side. Okay, producer gas is removed at the bottom side. Okay, fuel and gas move in the same direction. Fuel and gas move in the same direction here. The biomass fuel is admitted at the top, similar to the updraft gasifier. What we use in the updraft gasifier, we here biomass feed. Okay, upside it is feedstock, similar to the updraft gasifier. As the feed progresses down through the gasifier, it dries and it volatiles and pyrolyzed. Okay, if after feeding, that biomass feed is will come here, and first process is drying, it will dry, and some volatiles are pyrolyzed, it is removed. Okay, some volatiles compounds we get. The char is directed into reduced diameter cylindrical throat section at the bottom of the gasifier. Charcoal we get here at the third stage. Gasification air is injected into the throat, that is throat, through openings in the throat valve. Due to the high temperature, existing at the throat section, existing at the throat section, tars and oil could be cracked. That is the fourth combustion and cracking. Okay, in this process, adding air to burn and crack tar gases. That is what? Due to high temperature existing at the throat section, tars and oil could be cracked, which tend to form the producer gas, particularly when the biomass has more than 20% moisture content. Here, in step by step, the moisture content will be removed. Okay. The producer gas lives at the bottom of the gasifier. In the what we get, the producer gas will live at the bottom of the gasifier. Here the difference is, you can observe air is injected at the bottom side, but here downdraft air is introduced at the above the oxidation zone in the gasifier. Here the applications are continuous baking ovens, batch type baking ovens. Continuous baking ovens means it may be used for bread, biscuits and paint. Batch type baking ovens means it is used for rotary oven for bread, and drying and curing means it is used for tea, coffee, mosquito coil and paper drying. Thermal fluid heaters, annealing furnaces, direct fired rotary, that is kilns, okay, K-I-L-N-S, okay, and boilers, IC engine. Cross draft gasifier. Here, this is the third one. Here, the biomass is fed to one side of the gasifier and the producer gas leaves to the other side. You can observe here, feed is here and the biomass is fed through one side of the gasifier and the producer gas leaves through the other side of the gasifier. Okay. In cross draft gasifier, the ash bin fire and reduction zone in cross draft gasifier are separated. That means they are saying that ash bin fire and reduction zone, they are all separated here. You can observe drying part, and this is the distillation zone and reduction zone. This is the hair and burning charcoal. Okay, this is a great what we have discussed. Ash pit. Okay, this is collected at the bottom side, and here you can biomass is fed to the drying chamber. Air enters the gasifier through a water-cooled nozzle mounted on one side of the firebox. You can observe air is entered here. The gasifier fire, water cooled nozzle. Okay, you can observe small water cooled nozzle mounted on one side of the firebox. Okay, one side of the firebox. It is not, air is not injected two side. Okay, it is only injected at one side. Okay, and that too here a water cooled small nozzle mounted. Okay. Confines its combustion and reduction near the air nozzle and high operating temperature. This operates on high operating temperature. The high operating temperature will affect the gas composition, such as high carbon monoxide and low hydrogen and methane content when dry fuels like charcoal is used. The high temperature will affect the gas composition. What happens here? The gas composition here, this process, gas composition, the when it is high temperature, that will affect the gas composition, such as it may be high carbon monoxide we can get, and low hydrogen and methane content when we use a dry fuel like charcoal is used. Okay, and it will operate well with the low ash dry biomass feed fuels. Okay, this will, if you want to get the good output, then it will operate with the low ash, which the biomass what we feed, the it should be a low ash dry biomass feed fuels. Okay, the biomass is fed in at the top at regular intervals of time, and it is converted to a series of process. Series of process means drying, pyrolysis, combustion, that is only. Okay, series of process into producer gas and ash. It as it moves down slowly through various zones of the gasifier. Next is a fluidized bed gasifier. It has been successfully used to convert prepared waste, that is, it may be wood waste, agricultural waste, or it may be refuse derived fuel, it into a clean fuel gas that can be used to fire various types of industrial equipment. Here, it is an improved version of fixed bed gasifiers. Okay, till now we have discussed fixed bed gasifier types. And this is a updated version, that is updated improved version, fluidized bed gasifier. This bed is made of an inert material such as sand, ash or charcoal. It is heated initially and the fuel is introduced when the temperature has reached the appropriate level. Okay, they are saying that this bed is made of an inert material and it is heated initially, and the fuel is introduced when the temperature has reached the appropriate level. Okay, for example, it should reach 1000 degrees Celsius, means after reaching the 1000 degrees Celsius only the fuel is introduced there. Okay, that is what they are saying. The bed material transfers heat to the fuel. The bed material will transfer heat to the fuel. You can observe this is the output gas, cyclone and recirculation of the fines, and this is the fuel, and this is the distributor plate, fluidized bed. Okay, the BED it is. Okay, air, oxygen or steam. This is an inlet. Okay, this is output ash. Fluidized bed gasifiers have no distinct reaction zones, and drying, pyrolysis and gasifications occur simultaneously. They are saying that in this fluidized bed gasifier there are no different zones. Okay, they are combined. They have no distinct reaction zones. Drying, pyrolysis and gasification, that process, what is, three process occur simultaneously. Okay, the fuel particles are introduced at the bottom of the reactor. They are saying that the fuel particles are introduced at the bottom of the reactor very quickly. It is very quickly mixed with the bed material and almost instantaneously heated up to the bed temperature. The fuel, what we put here, the fuel particles are introduced at the bottom side. Okay, bottom of the reactor, and it is mixed very quickly, and it is we it will reach to the bed temperature, heated up to the bed temperature. As a result, fuel is pyrolyzed fast, resulting in a component mixed with a relative large amount of gaseous material. Further gasification and thermal conversion reactions occur in the gas phase. This is about the fluidized bed gasifier. In next class, we shall discuss about the comparison between these three, that is updraft and downdraft and crossdraft, and also we shall discuss about the benefits and some more other topics, use of biomass gasifier, and we shall discuss about the characteristics. Okay.